There are two ways to change relative humidity. One, change specific humidity. The other is change temperature. There are also two rules. Rule number two is this. If there's a fixed amount of water vapor in the air, then as air temperature rises, relative humidity decreases. And as air temperature decreases, relative humidity rises. If there's a fixed amount of water vapor in the air, that part means that the specific humidity does not change. The actual amount of water vapor in the air does not change for some given amount of time, let's say 24 hours. But temperature is going to go through its typical diurnal cycle, which is coldest right about the time that the sun rises, and then warmest sometime 2, 3 hours, 4 hours even, after the sun reaches its highest point in the sky, the daily march of temperature, in other words. And if you notice, as air temperature rises, relative humidity decreases, and as air temperature decreases, relative humidity rises, this is an inverse relationship. One thing is going up, the other thing is going down. What time of the day do you find dew on your car? Think about it. In the morning or in the afternoon? The morning, of course, because it's cooler. What happens in the afternoon? It's warmer, so there's not going to be any dew. Because as air temperature rises, relative humidity decreases. In order to make something happen, you're going to have to reach 100% relative humidity. So in the afternoon, it's just too warm for that. Take a look at this graph. Notice the relationship. Can you see what the relationship is? The dotted pink line represents air temperature. The solid line represents relative humidity. This is a graph that goes from 6 a.m. until 5 p.m. Notice that when air temperature is at its lowest, relative humidity is at its highest. And when air temperature is at its highest, relative humidity is at its lowest. Let's take a look at this graph. So this is a more complete graph. Notice this is a 24-hour graph, kind of what I just mentioned a moment ago. Goes from midnight to midnight, 12 a.m. to 12 a.m., right? You can see that. Then notice when air temperature, which is represented by the dotted line, is at its lowest, relative humidity, which is represented by the solid line, is going to be at its highest. And when air temperature is at its highest, relative humidity is at its lowest. If you can tell by looking at the graph, look what time of day these things are going to be happening. Relative humidity is going to be at its highest. Let's assume the sun rises at 6 a.m. on this particular day, right about the time the sun rises. And if we assume that the sun reaches its zenith, its peak in the sky at noon, and 2 to 4 hours later, the temperature will reach its highest point, notice that relative humidity is going to be at its lowest right about that time of the day because the temperature is at its highest. Okay, the dew point temperature. This is the temperature at which an air mass becomes saturated. The relative humidity is 100%. At that point, in other words, at that temperature, either condensation or sublimation will occur. Temperature. All right, here's the thing with using this word. Dew point temperature and air temperature are not the same thing. They are related, but they are not the same thing. Just because they use the word temperature does not mean that they are exactly the same thing. And you have to kind of digest that fact. Air temperature is the energy contained in the atmospheric molecules. In other words, if I said to you, it's 65 degrees today, you know what that means. And then if I said to you, tomorrow it's going to be 95 degrees, you know exactly what I'm talking about. You can tell the difference between those two things. Dew point temperature is a description of the water vapor in the air. It's different. This is going to give you an idea of what relative humidity is, how humid it feels outside. So even though they're both using the word temperature, they do not mean exactly the same thing, although they are related to each other, and they both have to do with temperatures. So if the dew point temperature is 47 and the air temperature is 65, so notice they are not the same number at this moment. Dew point temperature is representing water in the atmosphere. Air temperature is representing the energy in the atmosphere. If the dew point temperature is 47 and the air temperature is 65, again, you know what 65 degrees feels like. But then the air temperature drops down to 47 degrees. At that point, the air temperature and the dew point temperature will be the same number. They will be 47 degrees. We can also say at that moment, the relative humidity is 100% and the air is saturated and something will begin to happen. It's a little bit like if you think back to the glasses. If you have a 12-ounce glass and there's 12 ounces of water in it, it's 100% full. Whereas if you have a 12-ounce glass and there's 6 ounces of water in it, it's only 50% full. These three things always go together. First, when air temperature and dew point temperature are the same number, we can also say the relative humidity is 100% and the air is saturated. Likewise, if I said the air is saturated, you also know the relative humidity is 100% and the air temperature and the dew point temperature must be the same number. If I say the relative humidity is 100%, air temperature, dew point temperature must be the same number and the air is saturated. These three things are hand in glove. They always go together. You cannot have one without the other. Anytime you have one of those three, you automatically have all three of those. And at that point, something is going to happen. Let's take a look at this little thing that I constructed, right? So dew point temperature is over there on the left-hand side. It's 55 degrees. Air temperature is on the right-hand side. It's 75 degrees. What's going to happen is air temperature is going to begin to drop. As long as air temperature and dew point temperature are not the same number, the relative humidity is not 100%, which means we are not going to get any visual manifestation. Dew, frost, snow, rain, hail. It's not going to happen. We have to have 100% relative humidity in order to make that happen. But now what begins to happen is that air temperature at 75 degrees begins to drop. The temperature begins to go down. Now it's at 70. Now it's at 65. Look at the, can you see how the lines are getting closer to each other? Now it's at 60. Guess what happens next? Now the air temperature and the dew point temperature are both 55 degrees. At that moment, the relative humidity is 100%. The air is saturated and something is going to begin to happen. What that something is, we don't know yet. That's coming next. Again, with dew point temperature, if the dew point temperature is above 32 degrees Fahrenheit and the relative humidity is 100%, condensation will occur, which means gas to liquid. If, however, the dew point temperature is 32 degrees Fahrenheit or lower, and the air saturates, the relative humidity becomes 100%, sublimation will occur, which means gas to solid. This is also deposition, depending on what terminology you want to use, but sublimation or deposition, either one. If the dew point temperature is 47 degrees and the air temperature drops to 47 degrees, which process will occur? Condensation or sublimation? What's the answer? You over there on the right-hand side. Condensation, excellent, because 47 is a higher number than 32, outstanding. If the dew point temperature is 27 and the air temperature drops to 27 degrees, which process will occur? Condensation or sublimation? Raise your hand. If the dew point temperature is 27 and the air temperature is dropping, it reaches 27 degrees, which process will occur? Condensation or sublimation? Raise your hand. Okay, you over here on the left. What is it? Sublimation. Excellent. This is the way it works. When we get to the next video, we are going to begin to see the visual manifestations of condensation and sublimation. But these are the principles, these first few videos that I laid out for you, these are the principles that you have to wrap your head around to get what happens next.